Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. My name is Christian, but you can call me Spot.
Oh, Spotty!
I produce the Covino and Rich Show on Maxim Radio on Sirius Satellite Radio. I also haven't been late in a while, but here's where I can turn it all around. We're taking the show to Arizona for the Super Bowl.
Welcome to Phoenix, baby.
And while I'm out there, I need to get my hands on some booty. And you get to watch it all unfold. This is On the Level 2.
Spot's aggressive enough to really like push Rich, you know what I mean? Or, you know, like, if he does, he'll be like, I've had enough, you know, he turns into like a little fruity guy.
Spot predicting a fight with me. Dude, he doesn't want to mix it up with the devil. I will destroy him.
Rich is gonna have his views, and I'm gonna have my views, and they're just gonna one day and
So are they sleeping right now? Time to get up in the morning. Hello!
Time to wake up!
Time to wake up in the morning!
There have been times where I've just wanted to take him and knock him over and put his head through a plate glass window. If I could find one.
By me like telling you to go get some, is that being encouraging or is that being like obnoxious?
If you were like, hey Spotty, that girl's cute, you know, why don't you go up to her and say hi or whatever? That's fine. He's like, okay, Spot, you gotta go in, you know.
But it's all practice. It's practice. Like at the airport with those girls by the terminal.
Yeah, but then I know that your three doofuses are standing behind me watching my every little move and making fun of me if I fuck up. I don't want that.
Spot doesn't complain too much, but he does complain about not getting ass. But it's the fact that he actually complains about it that makes us frustrated with him. Well, then do something about it, you know? If you want to ask, go out there and get it.
I think Spot's complacent. I think Spot has got to a point where he's okay without getting ass. My intent is for Spot to try to step up his own life. And if it comes across like an asshole, I don't care, because deep down inside, my intentions are good.
We're not putting you down. We're not trying to insult you. We're trying to motivate you when we're buddies.
You always put me down to motivate me.
That's my style.
Both of you put me down. Just Rich a little more than Covino, that's why I hate Rich more.
With the Madden EA party later that evening, Spot and the boys went out and started their first full day in Arizona.
Scott visited Dale.
We have a new friend with us on day two in Arizona, man. We got three new friends. Her and her kids.
Your name?
Jen Sturger.
Alrighty. And how do you know Spot?
Spot and I met probably about, I don't know, I guess a year ago.
Jen Sturger is a big supporter in the cause for me to get ass.
I think Jen has confidence in him beyond us, though, because she doesn't know him. Like, she's like, Spot's a good guy, he's shy, and we'll break him out of his shell. Not so fast, Miss Jen Sturger. Not that easy.
Christian doesn't really come right out with his feelings until he gets to know you. So, I mean, my first impression was that he's a little on the eccentric side. Sometimes the things that he brings up in conversation, case in point, our conversation at US Egg, it's not something you would typically discuss with someone, especially a girl. I mean, I could tell right away the guy had absolutely no game.
No, I was telling you, I watched this documentary on how utensils are made.
Spot's choice of conversation sometimes is not on point.
And they're like flat things, and then they put them down in like this press, and it just goes, psh, and you have to fork.
His interests are not the things that women want to hear about.
But the knives are actually like, it's like this side and this side, and then they like put metal like shavings in, and then they heat it up and like dip it in hot liquid, and then it fuses, and you can't see the things on the side.
Who talks to women about making silverware? Seriously.
And then they fill it with cement.
This is what not to say to a girl tonight at the party.
I happen to watch a documentary about forks and knives and spoons.
Alright? That interests me, okay? I bet you it interests you. You know what? You use a fork and a knife and a spoon every day. I bet you don't know how they're made.
Watch Knowing things gets you ahead in life. It just doesn't get you ahead, okay?
ASU has some of the hottest college co-heads. But I think the reason we took him to ASU was just so that he could kind of get his feet wet, you know? You don't step into the major leagues and, you know, start hitting home runs on your first day. You gotta work your way up through the minors, and I think that's what we were trying to do with Spot.
Ace! That's what Spotty's here to get. Just take some time, little girl, in a little
hot blue ride, elephant. Dude, Spot, you get your mojo.
It's got mojo.
Sweet. He needs mojo.
Have a little more leverage with these college girls and these college kids. He's a grown man at this point.
These girls are looking at it. Look, see? These girls. Oh, hey, what's up? What's going on?
What up?
Here's what's going on, and this is exactly what I didn't want to go on. You have these three doofuses. Jen, you're a doofus too. Fucking be like, hey, Spotty, go talk to her. Go talk to her.
What's our angle?
Yeah, I know. What's my angle?
You work for Maxim, and you're looking for hometown hotties. Come on, it's not that hard, dude. I could hit on these chicks.
Then why don't you?
I think Spot makes himself uncomfortable. He lets that moment of opportunity pass by him, and he just waves at it.
Are you gonna stand here, dude, or not?
You're making me get inside my own head. You're making me freak myself out.
Do it.
Come on, dude.
He's a 27-year-old dude that works for Maxim.
Yo, for Maxim.
These are college chicks. Like, if he can't run his game on these girls, then he's a failure.
I don't think Spot likes being looked at as like a charity case. That's why I think he's better off on his own. I think Spot would be better off doing his own thing. Like, all right, guys, thanks for your support. But I'm going to go off and try to, you know, take a little bit of what everybody told me and get some ass on my own. Because when there's too many people there, I think it's just too much pressure on him.
If I were alone, I would probably be better off than if this were going on.
Listen closely. If none of us were there, he would not even thought of going up to these girls. So any thought that we cramped him to the point where he would have normally gone up to these girls, get that out of your head, because that wouldn't have happened.
You know the saying, he who hesitates masturbates?
Yeah.
You hesitated? And you're not masturbating. But look who stepped in, man. These two dudes. You waited, now these guys claim the territory.
What could happen? Two douches sat with me.
Two weak-ass dudes sat with her. That could be you. Only last week.
If I want to do something, I'll do it. That's why forcing me into these situations and sitting and staring at me and being like, go, and just waiting for me to do these things is not going to work. You don't
understand me. I was disappointed because, like I said, if you can't get your feet wet in a situation like ASU, where it's just, there's a plethora of hot girls. And why do you feel
the need to tease me? We were all frustrated. We're like, you know, I'm wiping my hands clean of this. Get your own ass. I'm done with you. Like, we were frustrated with the guy. You're done with him. You can't motivate this guy. There's always another point of view. Left that campus thinking, this may be useless. This may be out of our hands.
Something you'd like to say?
I think my look says it all.
I don't know. Maybe Kavino and Rich and Jen were disappointed in me. You know, maybe they're losing hope at the fact that I'm not, you know, doing these things that they want me to do. Or maybe they're slowly realizing that they can't make me do these things, you know?
I just feel like you sell yourself short. You see all these girls, and you're always saying, you don't get any girls, and you haven't cranked it for a month, but you're not doing anything to change that.
Having them make me do these things, and then me not doing them, and then them being disappointed in me, it's making me feel like a failure, you know? It's like I look at myself, and I'm like, great, now, you know, I'm not doing this. I'm a loser. I'm even more of a loser because I'm not, you know, these things aren't happening. I'm doing something wrong, and now my friends think I'm a loser, so that's even worse.